Hello students, in the previous video we started with exercise 1.1 rational irrational and we solved question number 1, 2 and 3. The question number 3b I gave you for homework. If you have solved it correctly, if you have got the answer right, you can send me your solution, I'll check it. Today we'll start with question number 4. Simplify the following. Very easy question. Let's see. In this question, minus 5 upon 13 plus 12 upon 13. We have to solve this. See, understand. The base is same here. The base. If the base is same, denominator is same, denominator, then we'll write the denominator as common like this. No need to take LCM, denominator is same. So, and you will add the numerators. So, minus 5 plus 12. What is minus 5 plus 12? It is 7 upon 13. Answer is 7 upon 13. Okay, very easy question. B, minus 8 upon 15 plus minus 7 upon 15. Again here, see, the base is same, the denominator is same, no need to take LCM, write the denominator as common and the numerators will get added. So minus 8 plus minus 7, so plus minus is minus, this will be minus 8 minus 7 upon 15. And what is minus 8 minus 7? It is minus 15 upon 15. So 15 ones are 15 ones are. What will remain? Answer is minus 1. Very easy question. Denominator is same, so no need to take LCM. This is C. In this question again, denominators are same, so add the numerators. Write the denominator as common, 25, and add the numerator. So 21 minus 16 plus 7. Okay, if there is already a minus sign, you take minus, otherwise you have to add. Then what is 21 minus 16 is 5 plus 7 upon 25, and what is 5 plus 7? It is 12 upon 25. So answer is 12 upon 25. Copy it neatly in your book. D, 5 upon 12 minus 7 upon 36. Here you see the denominator is not same. Here the denominator is 36 and here it is 12. We have to make the denominators same. Making the denominator same means we have to take LCM. So how to make this 12 into 36? 12 threes are 36. Correct. 12 into 3 is 36. So I will multiply the numerator and denominator by 3. What will happen if I multiply the numerator and denominator by 3? The numerator will become 3 fives are 15 upon denominator will become 12 threes are 36 minus 7 upon 36. Okay, so this, now the denominator is same. Now if the denominator is same, I can subtract the numerators. So I can write them directly, 15 minus 7. What is 15 minus 7? It is 8. 8 upon 36. And it is possible to cancel 8 upon 36. Cancellation is possible. So I'll do the cancellation here. This will become 2 4s are 2 18, 2 2s are 2 9s are. So final answer is 2 upon 9. Okay. I hope you have understood. We'll do the next sum now. Next question. E. Minus 8 upon 17 plus minus 4 upon 51.
Minus 8 upon 17 plus minus 4 upon 51.
Here also the denominator is not same. So to make the denominator same, if you observe carefully, how can you make this 17 into 51? If you multiply 17 with 3, it will become 51.
So I will multiply the numerator and denominator here with 3. So 8 3s are minus 24 upon, I'm sorry, minus 24 upon 17 3s are 51 plus minus 4 upon 51.
Now the denominator is same, so we can directly write the numerators. Denominator is 51, numerator is 24 minus 4. See, plus minus is minus. So 24 minus 24 minus 4. Minus 24 minus 4 is minus 28 upon 51. This is my answer. Okay, copy the question. Copy the solution properly. Now the last one, that is F. This question F has three terms, like the question C.
Minus 5 upon 16 plus 7 upon 24 minus 13 upon 48.
Here we have to make the denominators same, that is we have to take LCM. So how to take the LCM? See, the LCM of these three numbers is 48. So how can you make 24 into 48? We'll multiply this 24 by 2. And how can we make this 16 into 48? We'll multiply this 16 with 3.
See, multiply the numerator and denominator by 3. And for this, multiply the numerator and denominator by 2. So 3 5s are 15. 16 3s are 48. Plus 7 2s are 14, 24 into 2, 48, minus 13 upon 48. Now that in a base is denominator is same, so we can add the numerators. So 15 plus 14 minus 13. Okay, so 15 plus 14 is 29. Minus 13 upon 48, and 29 minus 13 is 16 upon 48.
Here, just a second, we made a small mistake here. This was minus 5, correct? This was minus 5, so this will be minus 15.
Okay, so this will be, this step went wrong. So here, after this step, minus 15 plus 14 minus 3. I'll solve this first. 14 minus 3. What is 14 minus 3? 14 minus 3 is plus 1. So I will get minus 15 plus 1 upon 48. Minus 15 plus 1 is minus 14 upon 48. Now I can cancel it with 2. 2 7s are, 2 2s are, 4s are. So final answer is minus 7 upon 24. Okay. A small mistake we made here while copying the sign. Just to rectify it. Copy the sum properly. Now, question number 5. A. Very easy question, so I am doing it here. Very small question. It is minus 11 upon 9 into minus 81 upon 88. So, there is a multiplication sign here. This multiplication sign means we will cancel the numerators and denominators, whatever possible. So, see. 9 9s are 81, okay, and 11 8s are 88. So what is remaining here? Minus 1 into minus 9 upon 8. So minus minus becomes plus, correct? Minus minus becomes plus. So answer is 9 upon 8. See, this 1 into 9 is 9. Minus minus became plus. So answer is 9 upon 8. Very easy question. Second one. B. 8 upon minus 9 into 16 upon minus 7. Here, no cancellation is possible. So no cancellation. But here minus minus will become plus. Minus minus sign will become plus. So the answer will be, this is, we are doing question number 5. 16 into 8. 16 into 8 is 128, and 9 into 7 is 63. If we convert it into mixed fraction, we'll get 2 2 upon 63. How to convert into mixed fraction? If you don't know, see, understand. If this is the number, we have to convert into mixed fraction. What will I do? I will divide 128 by 63. 63 2s are 126. Remainder is 2. So this number 63 will remain in denominator. Okay. Whatever quotient you get here, that quotient will come here. And the remainder will become the numerator. Okay. Then C. You can pause the video and copy the questions properly. Copy the solution properly and maintain your notebook. Next, C1. C is 6 upon 7 into minus 49 upon 63. 6 upon 7 into minus 49 upon 36. Let's do the cancellations. See, 7 ones are 7, 7s are 49, 6 ones are 6, 6 are 36. So what is remaining? 1 doesn't count. Minus 7 upon 1 into 6, 6.
minus 7 upon 6. And you write it in mixed fraction. How to do it in mixed fraction? 6 and 7. 6 ones are 6, remainder is 1. So mixed fraction is 1, 1 upon 6. And minus sign will come here. Okay. Copy the sum. Next, C is done. Now we'll do D. The D question. C. Minus 5 upon 9 into 49 upon 56 into minus 72 upon 35. Okay, and there is multiplication sign in between for each of the numbers. So we'll do cancellations first, whatever cancellation is possible. So 5, you can see 5 here. So 5 ones are 5, 7s are here. 7 and 49 can get cancelled. 7 ones are 7, 7s are 49. Okay, then we can cancel this 9 and 72. We know 9 9s are 81, 9 8s are 72. So 9 1s are 9 8s are, there is minus sign also. Okay, then this 8 and 56 can get cancelled. So 2 4s are 2, 28, 2 2s are 2, 14s are 2, 1s are 2, 7s are. Okay, and this 7 and this 7 can get cancelled. 7, 1s are 7, 1s are. So there is 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. All 1 are remaining, and there is minus minus sign. So minus minus will become plus, and 1 into 1 into 1 will nothing but 1. So basically answer is 1 for this question. Very easy cancellations. Next, E. E is minus 8 upon 17. Sorry. E is minus 13 upon 9 divided by 26 upon 27. Now here we have done the chapter exponents. There we studied a rule. We'll use that rule here. What was the rule? The rule was, see, what was the rule which we studied? That if there is a division sign, if you want to make this division sign into multiplication, you will have to reciprocal this fraction. So whichever fraction you have after the division sign, this is a fraction 26 upon 27. If you make this division sign multiplication, this 26 upon 27 will become ulta. It will get inverted. It will become 27 upon 26. Okay, so remember this, division became multiplication, 26 upon 27 became 27 upon 26. Now we can do cancellations. 3 3s are, 3 9s are, 3 1s are, 3 3s are. 13 and 26, 13 ones are, 13 twos are. So that is minus 3 upon 2. Answer is minus 3 upon 2. And if you make it in mixed fraction, it will become minus 1, 1 upon 2. Copy this. क्वेश्चन एफ इज -25 अपॉन 7 डिवाइड बाय 15 अपॉन 14. दिस डिविजन साइन वी कैन चेंज इन टू मल्टीप्लीकेशन बाय इन्वर्टिंग दिस फ्रैक्शन, रेसिप्रोकलिंग दिस फ्रैक्शन. सो दिस विल बिकम -25/7. दिस डिविजन आई विल मेक इट मल्टीप्लीकेशन लाइक आई डिड हियर, एंड 15/14 विल बिकम 14/15. नाउ ट्राई द कैलकुलेशंस ऑन योर ओन. ट्राई, आई एम वेटिंग फॉर अ सेकेंड. I hope you have got the right answer. You can check behind. Even I'll solve it. 5 5s are 5 3s are 7 1s are 7 2s are. So -5 × 2 -10/3. And I divide it. 3 3s are 9. Remainder is 1. So in the denominator I have 3. Quotient is 3. That will come here and remainder will come here. And there is negative sign. So -3/3 is the answer. Okay. Copy the sum. Now, question number 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. We have completed 5 questions. Now see, the question number 6 and question number 7, they are objective type questions in true or false. They don't come in exam. Okay, so leave them. They are not important. We'll come to exercise 1.2. Now in exercise 1.2, question number 1. In fact, in exercise 1.2, question number 1, 2, 3 and 4 are not questions which will come in exam. They are those type of questions which will check your concept, like filling the blanks, identification, something. They are for revision actually in the exercise. The exercise actually starts from question number 5. But let's revise these questions. First is, which of the following pairs is not additive inverse? Not additive inverse of each other. What is additive inverse? First of all, additive inverse means that when you add both the numbers, the answer should be 0. That means it is a additive inverse. But they are asking us, which of the following is not a additive inverse? Not means we have to find which is not additive inverse. Additive inverse means, in simple words, when you add, you must get 0. If you get 0, means it is additive inverse. Not additive inverse means it should not get 0. So let's see the question A. 11/15 and -11/15. See, 11/15 -11/15 will get cancelled. Correct. See, you can solve it like this. 15 denominator is same. 11 - 11 is 0. 0/15 is 0. Answer is getting 0 means this is additive inverse, but we want not additive inverse. Okay, so this is not the answer. This is additive inverse, but they are asking us to identify which of the following is not additive inverse. So let's see the B one. B is -17/21 and 17/21. When I add them, -17/21 +17/21, minus plus will get cancelled, so I'll get the answer 0. This is also additive inverse.
but I want to identify which is not additive inverse. Let's solve and see. C1 minus 8, sorry, 8 upon minus 9 and 8 upon 9. Okay, I told you in the previous video also that this minus sign, if it is in the denominator, it means that this sign is for the entire fraction. It is as good as minus 8 upon 9 plus 8 upon 9. We'll add this both. So minus 8 upon 9 plus 8 upon 9 minus plus will become 0. So this is also additive inverse. We want the one which is not additive inverse. So let's check the D1. D is minus 25 upon minus 52 and 25 upon 52. Here, if I add them, first of all, this minus minus numerator and denominator will get cancelled. So I will get 25 upon 52 plus 25 upon 52. It will get added. So it will become 52 in the denominator. 25 plus 25 is 50. If I cancel, I'll get the answer 25 upon 26. That means I'm getting the answer here. I'm not getting 0. That means this is not a additive inverse. Okay, if you get 0, it is additive inverse. If you don't get 0, it is not a additive inverse. And we had to find not a additive inverse. Okay, so D is your answer. Copy this. They are asking which of the following are reciprocals. We have to see what are reciprocals. Numerator becomes denominator and denominator becomes numerator. But one thing you have to remember, when you reciprocal something, sign does not change. Okay, sign should be same. I'll write here a hint for you. Sign should be same. Even if you reciprocal, sign should be same. So in the question they are saying, first one, 2a, 12 upon 17 and minus 17 upon minus 12. So this minus minus will get cancelled. This is 12 upon 17, this is 17 upon 12. Ulta hai, iska ulta ye hai, correct? It is reciprocal. Yes, the answer is yes, it is reciprocal. Just we have to say yes or no, it is reciprocal or it is not a reciprocal. B. B is minus 13 upon 27 and 27 upon 13. Here also you have minus 13 upon 27 and there is 27 upon 13. Numbers are reciprocal, but sign is not same. You see, there is minus sign here and there is plus sign here. I said if you reciprocal something, sign should be same. The sign is not same. So no, it is not a reciprocal. Okay, C, 1 upon 9, 9 upon minus 1. Again here, numbers are getting inverted, but sign is not same. Okay, so here also the answer will be same. No, it is not reciprocal. D, minus 1, 3 upon 5 and 5 upon 8. So here let's solve the mixed fraction. Solve this mixed fraction. 5 into 1 is 5. 5 plus 3 is 8. So this is minus 8 upon 5 and this is 5 upon 8. Again the same problem. Numbers are inverted. Numbers are right. 8 upon 5 became 5 upon 8. But sign is not same. So no, this is also not a reciprocal. So only this was the answer. We had to choose one answer. So A is my answer. Okay. Copy this. pause the video and copy it. Maintain your classwork book complete. Each and everything should be there in it. In fact, in your school also, if school gives you any notes, any importance, any markings, you must note that. Question number three. Multiplicative inverse. What is multiplicative inverse? Means that when you multiply, question is minus 3 upon 5 into minus 8 upon 11. This is the question. Multiplicative inverse means you will solve this first. Minus minus becomes plus. 3 into 8 is 24. 5 into 11 is 55. You got this answer. Multiplicative inverse of this is whatever answer you get, just reciprocal the answer. That is your final answer. See, when we multiply, I got this. Reciprocal of this is 55 upon 24. This is my answer. Whenever they ask you to find multiplicative inverse, just solve it and invert the answer. Okay. Multiplicative inverse means when you multiply these two, the answer is 1. Okay, because see, when you multiply 24 upon 55 into 55 upon 24, 24, 24 cancel, 55, 55 cancel, answer is 1. Multiplicative inverse means ke isko kiske saath multiply karunga to answer 1 aayega. Kiske saath karenge to jo iska ulta hoga. Correct. The reciprocal of this fraction will give me the answer 1. So isiliye jo bhi answer aata hai usko reciprocal karo. This is your final answer. This is called as multiplicative inverse. Now question 4 is not important. Okay, that is name the property. It is about name the property. This type of questions don't come in exam. Name the property. Leave this or I'll write it to be done later. When the classes will start, while revision, we'll see if school does, in the school notebook, I'll see what pattern is followed by the teacher, and then we'll do this question. Okay. Actually, this type of questions don't come in exam. Exam has questions that are to be solved. Okay. Name the property and all doesn't come in maths subject. Okay. So we will not waste time. We'll start with question number 5. Question number 5, we have simplify. The first one is minus 7 upon 12 plus 13 upon 15. We have to simplify this, solve this. How will we do it? We have to take LCM here. What is the LCM of 12 and 15? See, if you don't know to take LCM, you can use this method. 12, 15. Start with 2. 2 6s are not divisible. Copy as it is. 2 3s are not divisible. Then 2 will not work. We'll take 3. 3 1s are, 3 5s are. Then not divisible by 3 also, both the numbers. So I'll take 5. 1 will remain as it is. 5 1s are 5. So multiply these 4 numbers. 2 into 2 into 3 into 5, that is the LCM. Four 3s are 12, 12 5s are 60 is the LCM. Okay, so 60 is the LCM means we have to make the denominators 60.
How to make the denominator 60C? I'll solve the sum here. I have minus 7 upon 12 and 13 upon 15. So if I want to make this denominator 60, I'll have to multiply them by 4. 15 fours are 60. So multiply the numerator and denominator by 4. Here I want to make this 12 as 60. So multiply the numerator and denominator by 5. Minus 7 into 5, minus 35. 12 into 5, 60. Plus 13 into 4, 52. 15 into 4, 60. See, you took LCM, denominators became same. So now denominator will come common, minus 35 plus 52. When you solve this, 52 minus 35, you will get as 17 upon 60. So final answer is 17 upon 60. Okay, we have done the first term. Now the B, C, D and question number 6, we'll do it in next video. Next video we'll try to complete this exercise. Okay, that's it for today. Thank you.